Hey guys, welcome back to another Tech Tip. In today's video, we're going to look at advanced functions of your mouse. So in the past, we did a video on basic mouse functions. It was left click and right click. You can go ahead and see that by clicking up the card in the top right hand corner. Otherwise, if you're new here, we do a lot of tech channels, a lot of how-tos, a lot of tutorials, videos just like this one. So let's get to it. So because there's so many different options when it comes to your mouse and so many different tabs, there's about 5 different tabs full of information that we can go through. We're gonna go on over to the computer here and take a look. As with most videos that we make on this channel, a lot of the instructions are very similar. Of course, they may vary from operating system to operating system. I am on Windows 10, but again, the instructions will be very similar. What you'll want to do is come on down to the Start menu in the bottom left-hand corner and left-click it. And then here you can begin typing the word mouse. Again, you can do this on Windows 7, 8, 8.1, all the way up to 10. And what you'll want to do is click on the mouse option that comes up in the search results. And this will open another window that will give us all of the tabs and information that we're going to go over in this video today. So as you can see right here on the buttons tab, you can actually switch your primary and secondary buttons, making it to where if you're a left-handed person, it will make the mouse easier to operate. The right button will be left click and then vice versa. You can also double click the speed. You can increase that or slow it down depending on how you want it to be. If you want to be able to do fast double clicks for it to register opening a file, you can do that. Or if you need to slow it down, you're more than welcome to do that as well. Turn on click lock. This enables you to highlight or drag without holding down the mouse button. A lot of people don't like this because it kind of messes with the functionality of your mouse and can kind of create a problem as far as making it function normally. So we're going to go on over and move to the pointers tab. Here, this is where you can basically change the scheme or customize your arrows. You can, as you can see, if you have a theme pack for arrows, you can download that and then you can come in here and change it. I would not recommend going and downloading a bunch of those because a lot of them will actually contain some kind of malware or program that will infect the computer and actually can cause some problems as well. So just be careful when you're doing that. Moving on to pointer options. Here you can select a speed. If you know that your mouse is a little slow, you want to speed it up, you can come in here and drag this bar either left or right depending on if you want it to slow down or speed it up. It's completely up to you. Snap to automatically moves the pointer to the default button in a dialog box. So if you want it to snap to like a close button or a minimize button, once you get close to that, it will automatically snap to that. It is default unchecked because it can create a headache as far as functionality of the mouse. Visibility, if you have a hard time seeing the mouse, you can actually come in here, click display pointer trail, and you'll see that it will create a trail to make the mouse easier to follow. And of course, you can adjust the length of that trail. Hide pointer while typing. So if you're typing a message, the little arrow will disappear. If you don't like that, you can uncheck that and it will show the mouse pointer even when you are typing. Show the location of the pointer when I press the control key. So if you're having a hard time tracking the mouse, if you have this button checked, we'll go ahead and click apply on that. If you hit the control button, it'll give you a little blip on where that mouse is located, no matter where it is on the screen. So if it's hidden somewhere, you hit control, it'll give you a little blip showing you where that mouse is located. Moving on to the wheel tab, let me go ahead and uncheck these. Moving on to the wheel tab, you can have your scroll wheel on your mouse change the number of lines or move the number of lines that you have specified. So if you want it to move 5 different lines, so say you're reading an article and you want it to scroll 5 times or 5 lines worth of information instead of 3, you can come in here and enable or go ahead and set that to 5 and that will allow it to scroll a little bit quicker as well. Horizontal, a lot of mouse, if you have a wheel, will go left and right. It has a button on either side. And of course, you can change that as well, 3, depending on how many that you want. Last but not least, the hardware tab. Right here, this you won't spend a lot of time in, if any time at all, but what this does is allows you to go in and see what hardware as far as mouse is on the computer. As you can see, this is a Logitech gaming virtual mouse, but it just basically gives you basic information on what type of mouse it is and the name of the mouse. Hey guys, thanks for watching that tech tip. If you haven't already, hit the subscribe button right below me here. Give it a thumbs up if you like it. Share this video to anybody that you know could use this information. Also, don't forget to hit the little bell icon to make sure you receive our emails for future notifications. We will see you next time.